Welcome to Venice. Are you excited? Look at you. Smiling and stuff.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore.
We are in Mestre, Italy. As you can see by the train station sign behind me, coming off an 8-hour flight into Marco Polo Airport from Philadelphia. It is time to go to our hotel. We are both tired. It is approximately 11 a.m., but check-in is not until 3 p.m. So, just making a video before we head on out, just to introduce our trip. Say hello. Bye-bye. 7-minute walk from the train station to our hotel. There's a bus called ATVO. It'll get you right into Mestre train station. You can put your luggage underneath, and it's about a 15 to 20 minute ride. Very quick and easy. There's a lot of hotels in this area, so if you do stay in Mestre, your hotel is probably in walking distance because this town really isn't that big. So, just a little quick tip. This is my second time here, so first time I got a taxi, it was much more expensive, but I got round trip tickets for this bus thing, and it was 36 euros. Look like we're walking up on a hotel now. Stay City. Hey, here's our balcony, which is a little creepy actually. But here's it. Ooh, hey, hold up. And you can trip on this thing. Yo, almost tripped on that. So you can trip on this thing right into the back. Bruh, what's going on? Balcony a little creepy though. This is the view, because I guess it's the city. But I ain't getting too close because I don't like this right here. No thank you on that. Okay, day one. We got in a little nap real quick. And now we are just taking a stroll around the neighborhood that we're staying in. It's called Mestre. And there's a couple of things on the sightseeing list I wanted to see that we're in like 30 minutes walking distance. So the first one is called a Fort Marghera, I think. So just gonna go see that and go see a main square, and then grab some pizza and some gelato. So this is the neighborhood behind me. So Mestre is definitely not the prettiest town. It's a town, you know. I don't want to give nobody the impression that it's a town, and I'm not hating on it. It's just so you know, it's a town. There's a business district over by where I am that I'll get some footage for when I get an opportunity. But right now we're just walking through the streets. Looks like some back streets actually. But just some real views, you know. I don't feel unsafe. Although when I first took off, it was a little bit of a pee smell when we first started walking. But it's fine overall. Some kind of fruit tree right here. I look like a grape to me.
No, that's absolutely.
I mean, I'm not saying it is a grape. I'm saying it looks like a grape. A cherry or a peach? Oh, a small peach? That could be a small peach. I agree with that. This is definitely not a scenic route. I'm not complaining. I like to get out and walk and see things. So I'm not complaining, but just making a note. Just definitely not a scenic route. But nice to, you know, nice to say that you did it, you saw it, whatever. But after this, we'll be going to a plaza. I think it's a shopping plaza or a dining plaza, Ferretto. So that should be better. So it looked like we might have arrived close, or at least that dinosaur looking thing that says Parks of Mestre. So look, and then we just saw some people come out, and then you see those two people going in on their scooters. So I think we might have arrived. There's a guy coming up behind me jogging too, so let's see what's down here. It's kind of a bigger park area here than I actually thought, and I just felt a raindrop. Did you feel it?
Yeah.
You felt it? Mm-hmm. You scared? You want to turn around?
Where are we going
to go? Oh no, we're running into one of these trees or something. All right, let's keep going. Let's brave it. On the side of the bridge, you got a nice little brook over here. I think there's somebody on a boat coming by. Look, somebody up there, rowboat too. Cool, old cottage right there. All right, it's nice, pretty quiet, pretty relaxing. Let me get this side too. Water looks really green. I think we may have arrived. That looks like a fort opening. GPS says make a right. That also is a good indicator. Yeah, so. And there we go. And we will see. Got some families coming out of there. So this is what it looks like entering the fort. I did read the history on this place, but I have since forgotten. I had a lot of preparation to do for this trip. Like a lot. Learning a little Italian, trying to get the itinerary together. I just forgot, so somehow in the video I'll put some history about this place. I'll do what I can. But for now, just enjoy the views. Like there's some restaurants here too, like maybe people come here to, I'm pretty sure this is like a restaurant. I don't know if you can see down there in the camera, but I'm pretty sure those are restaurants down there. Not that many people right now, but it is Thursday afternoon, so it turns out that the long, not so aesthetically pleasing walk was actually worth it. This place is pretty cool. It's pretty nice, but good for photos. And I think that it doubles as a college campus. I'm pretty sure this building right here behind me is a dorm. I seen some, looked like students going in there. So it actually is worth it. It actually was worth it walking over here. So we'll continue on. I think she wants a photo because she's not walking anymore. So let me get this photo for her. So they got like a little, I guess that's a beer garden over there. But again, it's Thursday afternoon, so that explains the lack of folks. We'll make our way over this way, some water back there. Make our way over to the statue right here. Check that out. Okay, the sign says, "The slingshot represents our natural resources, which we are stretching beyond their limits. We can damage them or lose hold and launch the world into perdition. If we want to survive as a race, we must release the tension." You know what? Didn't even realize that rhymed the first time I read it. This looks like it was some kind of barracks. Don't know for sure, but that's what it looks like to me. There's some kind of sound coming out of here too. I think nobody's in there. It might be an animal or something. Which means it might be wise for me not to be creeping up on it. Oh, it was that bird. There it is. Pigeon. There you go. nice little canal front. I was going to say lake front, but it's more like a canal front right here. Got some folks chilling out, getting some fresh air. The weather is great out here right now too. It's like, I don't know what it is in Celsius, but it's about 80 degrees Fahrenheit with a light breeze. It's amazing. You filming me filming you? So Fort Marghera is complete, and we are on our way to Piazza Ferretto, and that is a 35-minute walk, which I was a little more than expected, but it's cool. We'll burn these calories out and get something good to eat tonight. All right, I know what I forgot to say. I told you that I think that it's a university on that fort. And I think it's a veterinarian university because I took some video and hopefully I can get it in here. It was like a cat sanctuary in there, and there were several like veterinary clinics in there too. And a lot of cats all over the place, and the students also. And then when we were walking in, I didn't get a video of, there was a university, a veterinary university, like a block or two before you got to the fort. So I think, I'm not sure at the moment, that it is a veterinary university intertwined with the fort. This is my hypothesis. I'll try to prove it or disprove it when I have an opportunity. But I got some water because I was thirsty. I hope I didn't have chapped lips on these videos. But we'll be walking on this little highway that doesn't look like it's for walking. But whatever. Just giving y'all a little scenery on the walk here. Looks like an apartment complex. People probably live here. Just like we got in the States. Some of the street. On our walk to Piazza Ferretto. Hopefully I'm pronouncing that right. Just some views. The tired one here. She can't hang today. Tell us why you can't hang.
Because I'm tired.
You're tired today? You didn't take your vitamins and your Wheaties?
And I worked yesterday.
I'll give her that. She works, she's a hairstylist. I wasn't sure if you wanted me to tell people. But, so she's on her feet a lot. I will give her some grace today, just today. Piazza Ferretto is just ahead. I do have the GPS on, so I'm pretty sure if we walk through this small walkway here, that we should run into it. Unfortunately, Sephora didn't have what she wanted, but it'll be next time, right? Maybe next time. And this is it. Piazza Ferretto. Here we go. You made it. You think you could do it?
I did.
Look at that. You know how strong you are until you have to do it. Nice too, pretty nice. I like it.
Somebody's getting tired. Ready to sit down and eat.
Yeah, it's contagious. You gave it to me.
We're trying to get to our pizza place so we can get out of the rain and get some food. Well, it's not raining yet, but it's supposed to rain. So we want to get there and get some food and then take it down.
Take it on down.
How is it going?
We are trying to beat the rain and the darkness right now and get to this pizza shop so we can have dinner. I don't know where I'm at. I'm following the GPS in my ear. And this hero will be worthless in the dark. So hopefully we can get on back there, get this food, because we have not really eaten nothing but chips and pretzels. But since yesterday, yeah. He cussing somebody out. Yeah, I don't know. He mad, but I'm hungry, so I can't worry about that. Look like they got a little Club McDonald's situation going on here. So my Philadelphia people, you know what that means, or especially if you're probably over 30. But this McDonald's is serious. This thing looks like a Walmart or something. But you got a bunch of people back there just hanging out in the parking lot. So this must be the place to be. This place is called Euro Pizza, recommended to us by the flight attendant from our flight. So we'll give you an update on how we like it. In Italy, watching Michael Jackson here. Can't beat this experience. Getting some pizza. Yeah, pizza. No, she wanted to do it. We got somebody on the turntables in there. I don't even know what this show is. They just start scratching up everyday people by Arrested Development. Okay. We did not beat the rain. But, you know, whatever it is, what it is. I got my pizza. And I'm definitely tired. And I hope it's good. That's all I got to say for this night. Goodbye. Big smile. I like it. That's what I like to see.